And just to remind you, I'm Susan Vita, the chief of the music division. And and in a minute, I'd like to hand the mic over to a good friend of the library, Dr. William Sloan, who will be telling us just a bit about the very special instrument we will hear in tonight's concert. We feel very fortunate tonight, and I'd like to spend a few moments explaining why. First, we are about to present a concert that honors a truly remarkable woman, Leonora Jackson McKim. She was a very significant violinist, extremely gifted with a major international career in an era when very few women reached the peak of the performing arts world. She became famous as a teenager, appearing with the Berlin Philharmonic in 1896 and earning tremendous respect as an artist on both sides of the Atlantic. If you've seen our brochure, with her arresting photograph on its cover, you will have a strong sense of what she was like as a young performer. I mean, what a picture, huh? Very creative, a painter, a composer, and a poet, as well as a formidable musician. McKim would become one of the five major donors of our concert series. McKim Fund, she established for us, has made possible 89 commissions for violin and piano. She would have been delighted to hear one of these this evening, Harold Meltzer's Kreisleriana, and also a new work by Aida Shirazi. Both composers are with us here tonight. Would they please stand and be recognized? Back to counting our blessings, we are also fortunate because Miranda Cuckson will be playing Leonora Jackson's McKim's Stradivari violin tonight. It has been lent to us for this occasion by longtime friends Dr. Sloan and his wife, Professor Judy Sloan. Judy's in the audience down there waving. They've come from California to bring this. It's kind of a culmination of a dream that they've had for many years with Anne McLean. And so we have the McKim violin played by a female violinist, and the McKim Fund funding it. And it's just really cool. We are so grateful to both of them for this generous gift of the and for the generous gift of the Oberlin Betts violin that they gave the library. That instrument, we took our own Betts Stradivari instrument violin to Oberlin College, and for 2 weeks, a series of violin makers copied it exactly using modern day technology like CT scans and things like that, and replicated the Betts. And after it was the first year, they built it. The second year, it came back and they did the varnishing for it. And then at the culmination of that, the Sloans donated it to the library. So we now have the Betts itself and the Betts copy. It sounds wonderful. We had a session here where we played both of them. So we are thrilled to partner with Dr. Sloan and Judy in honoring the McKim legacy here at the library. I know a few of you are in the audience are violin fanciers and aficionados, and it's exciting for us to share with you that hearing this beautiful instrument. And now it's my delight to introduce Dr. William Sloan, who with his wife, Professor Judy Sloan, has owned the McKim Stradivari violin since 1984.
privilege and an honor to speak before you. How many people here are from the Oberlin Violin Makers Workshop? I know there are two or three. Yes. And this violin was made by Stradivari in Cremona, Italy, 306 years ago in 1714. And he made many other famous violins that year, such as the one played by Isaac Broman called The Soil, and the one that used to be played by the concertmaster of Toscanini's NBC Orchestra called the Adam Strad. And these violins are supposed to be made from the same piece of maple, and that can be identified by many of the violin makers. This violin has a special sound because when Stradivari was 70 years old in 1714, he was about the peak of his golden period of making violins with the most beautiful tone. And Miss Cuckson, who played the violin today, has not seen that violin since yesterday when she was introduced to it, and she is totally in love with it. So you will hear her play this violin, which again, 306 years old. So the people who are playing it now, like when I play it, or Miss Cuckson or others, we're only a small blip in the history of this violin, which we're just the caretakers of it. It will be played many centuries down the line as long as it's kept in good condition. And I hope you enjoy the concert today because it's going to be something unusual. Thank you.
I just wanted to clarify, she's not playing the entire concert series on that. You'll be cued when she is playing on it, so you can really enjoy it.
Her other violin is a 1742 Guadagnini that was made in the early career of Guadagnini, who lived in Piacenza first when she made her violin. Later moved to Milano, and later moved to Turin. So he has three periods of violin making, and she will play her own violin, one of the pieces tonight, made in 1742 by Guadagnini.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.